Hey guys, it's Kennedy here with Precision Camera, and today we're going to be talking about the Canon EOS R10. I'm really excited about this camera because for those of us that are looking to get into the APS system, who maybe have never touched a mirrorless camera before, or just looking for that upgrade from our smartphones, this is probably going to be the best camera for you. This guy's coming in with 24.2 megapixels, a native ISO from 100 to 32,000, which can be expanded to about 51,000 if you're looking to kind of test that low light capability. So this great compact camera is going to be perfect for traveling. So for my influencers or enthusiasts who are looking for something that is going to be easy to move around just like your smartphone, this is going to be perfect for you. Now this camera is featuring Canon's new APS-C sensor. It's unlike mirrorless sensors that we've seen in the past that are backlit or have high speed stacking. Canon is improving high ISO noises and sensor readout as well in this new APS-C sensor. In the Canon EOS R10, we are seeing autofocus carried straight from the R3, so that face eye detection, animal tracking, subject tracking is still gonna be there, but what's really, really cool is now we have vehicle tracking. So if you're out there wanting to get those cool shots at the car show, or if you're at Circuit of the Americas and you wanna get that awesome Class A shot of the cars in the race, you will be good to go with the Canon EOS R10. Another point to add is this new autofocus and manual focus switch directly under your finger here under the grip. This is an important note to add because on the RFS lenses that we're seeing on these crop sensor cameras, you do no longer have the autofocus or manual focus dial feature. Now with Canon's APS-C cameras, we are seeing a new line of crop lenses. The RFS lenses here are really interesting because they are going to have that same full frame mount that we're used to on the R6 and the R5, which means if you are wanting to adapt over those full frame lenses from the R5 or the R6, you will be able to do so with the R10. It will just be at a 1.6 crop. So the external features that we're seeing on the Canon EOS R10 are gonna be the built-in flash, which we're not seeing a lot these days on mirrorless cameras, as well as your single card slot for UHS 2 V60. Also, we have a 3.5 millimeter mic jack, which to note, we do not have a headphone jack here on the R10, but we do have your micro HDMI and a USB-C port, which is great for on-the-go charging. This camera also features a fully articulated touch screen flip out LCD screen. So you're gonna be able to get the most access, the best angles, as well as it being a little bit more intuitive for your smartphone users. As for frames per second, this camera features 15 frames per second in mechanical and about 23 max in electronic. The Canon EOS R10 features 4K video uncropped unless shooting in 4K 60p. In that case, you do have to crop down, but you're not losing any resolution or any detail within the video. This makes it great if you're gonna pair it with an IBIS lens, so that way you can get the most out of the sensor, as well as keeping your video nice and leveled out. Now, when recording in 4K video in 24 or 30 frames per second, this is being oversampled from 6K. So that means your sharpness and your detail is gonna be excellent in your video recording and give you that nice, clear, crisp image that you are wanting overall. So another reason why the Canon EOS R10 is gonna be great for beginners is that these menu systems here come with explanations. So anytime that you change your menu system, you're gonna be told exactly what that menu setting is. Not any confusion or overwhelmingness from the menu. It's gonna give you exactly what you're looking at. Some other really cool features in this camera are gonna be your in-camera panoramic mode. So you literally just take the camera, start painting the room, and it builds the panoramic for you in camera, which is gonna save you a lot of time in post-production. Another awesome feature when especially you're doing video is gonna be that panning mode. So anytime that you're tilting or shifting the lens or the camera itself, it's gonna work to correct that shift or that tilt. This is gonna be a great camera for beginners, enthusiasts for videography and photography, influencers that are looking to get away from their smartphones for better image quality. This camera is definitely for you. The store is currently taking special orders on the Canon EOS R10. And they are listed at three different price points. So the body is starting at $979, and their two kits are gonna be listed just under $1,500. If you want some more information on those kits, they will be listed below. And again, thank you for watching. My name is Kennedy. Please come see me at the store. If you like this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you next time.